So there is a circular loop, and they're asking magnet, they're saying that the magnetic field at the center of the circle is B1. At a distance along the axis, at a distance which is exactly equal to radius of this circle, at a distance r, which is also equal to r, at this point, magnetic field is equal to B2. So here the magnetic field is B1, here the magnetic field is B2. So the question is, what is the ratio of B1 to B2? So magnetic field at the center of the circle is B1. Magnetic field at a point on its axis at a distance exactly equal to radius is B2. What is the ratio B1 is to B2? So then you know that magnetic field at the center of a circle is mu naught I divided by 2 r, where r stands for radius of the circle. At a distance x, suppose in the formula we have derived that this distance is x. If this radius is r, the distance is x, then the magnetic field at a distance at this point P equal to, we call here as B2, is mu naught I r square divided by 2 into r square plus x square whole power 3 by 2. But here the x is equal to r. That's what B2. So B2 will be equal to mu naught I r square divided by 2 into r square plus r square whole power 3 by 2. So mu naught I r square divided by 2 into 2 r square whole power 3 by 2. That means mu naught I r square by 2 into 2 r square whole power 3 by 2 means 2 power 3 by 2 into r square whole power 3 by 2. R square whole power 3 by 2 is 2 and 2 will be cancelled, r cube. This square and cube will be cancelled, only r will be left out. So 2 root 2 can be written as 2, I mean 2 whole power 3 by 2 can be written as 2 root 2. So this could be mu naught I divided by 2 times 2 root 2, 2 root 2 into r. So this is the expression for B2. What is the ratio B1 by B2? So B1 by B2. B1 is mu naught I divided by 2r, by B2 is mu naught I divided by 4 root 2 into, you can also write it this way, 2 times 2 root 2, 2 times 2 root 2 into r. Mu naught I will be cancelled, r and r will be cancelled, 2 and 2 will be cancelled. So this is in the denominator of the denominator. So this 2 root 2 goes up. So the answer is 2 root 2 by 1, or simply 2 root 2.